have therefore no condemnation to them which are in Christ Jesus, who walk not after the flesh, but after the Spirit. For the law of the Spirit of life in Christ Jesus has made me free from the law of sin and death. For what the law could not do in that it was weak through the flesh, God sending his own Son in the likeness of sinful flesh, and for sin condemned the sin in the flesh. For that the righteousness of the law might be fulfilled in us who walk not after the flesh, but after the Spirit. Let somebody say Spirit. For they that are after the flesh do mind the things of the flesh, but they that do after the Spirit, the things of the Spirit. For to be carnal minded is death, but to be spiritual minded is life and peace.
Amen.
We're going to stop right there. This scripture right here was penned by Paul. Here we see, he started off talking about there is no condemnation to them who are in Christ Jesus, who walks after the flesh, who walk not after the flesh, but after the Spirit.
That's right.
No condemnation. No guilt. No guilt in them. How can you not be guilty? What would you think about if you have been on death row? You would think, oh, you can't, have you ever imagined being on death row? Anybody ever imagined that? Well, guess what? I'm gonna tell you a secret. If you're not of Christ, you're on death row today.
Come on now, come on.
The word says, if you are not of Christ, you are dead. Why? Because you are born in sin and shaken in iniquity.
Yes.
Oh, man was meant to live forever.
Amen.
But Adam and Eve, Adam spoiled that for us.
Okay.
When Adam bit of the forbidden fruit, then we became qualified for death.
Yes.
I was born in sin.
Yes.
I told me I didn't have to do nothing but be born.
Amen.
After that, am I right, Pastor Paul? After that, all I have to do is be born. And I am a candidate. I'm on death row.
Yes.
Hallelujah. But I'm going to show you in a minute how you can be sentenced to death, yet you walk free.
Amen. I'm on preacher.
My subject would be guilt, but I'm walking free.
Amen.
Guilty, but I'm walking free.
Amen.
See, I'm guilty. I'm guilty of sin.
Mm-hmm.
I was guilty of being born in sin and sacred in iniquity. Nothing could I do. When I come here, that banger come, he came in sin.
Amen.
Everybody in here came in sin. But the word of God is going to tell us how we're going to transfer and make a transformation.
Amen.
I'm so glad God don't deal with us according to our actions.
That's right.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Number 2 said, for the law of the Spirit of life in Christ Jesus had made me free from the law of sin and death.
Yes.
There it is right there. Holy Spirit. But in the beginning, it was there the whole while.
Amen.
And when we became candidates and Adam failed, God then sent his Son. Jesus Christ made us free. Through the blood of Jesus, we became free. Even though I'm guilty, I can walk free.
Amen.
Even though I had a death sentence on me, Pastor Corey, I can walk free.
Amen.
Why? Because Jesus Christ died and took it off. He paid it off for me.
Yes, he did.
He paid it off. Then it goes for 3 saying, for what the law could not do, it was weak through the flesh.
Uh-huh.
God sending his own Son in the likeness of sinful flesh, and for sin condemned sin in the flesh. When Jesus came here, he was both flesh and divine.
Yeah.
He had to come. He had no choice.
Mm-hmm.
He was the lamb that was under the altar.
Come on,
he had to come. Had it not came, there was nobody else to reside us back to God.
Mm-hmm.
God made man for his own glory.
Yes.
But man disobeyed. Disobedience will get you a death sentence.
Amen.
Disobedience will put you on death row.
Yes, it will.
And then what you do, your family will pay. It's a curse. Sometimes you can do stuff. Call your children to pay. Sometimes you can do stuff. Call your whole family to be cursed.
Uh-huh.
One in the family.
Yeah.
end of that, you can't go to the safe school.
Uh-huh.
You can't go to the room worker. You can't go to those that think they know.
Uh-huh.
You can't, money can't pay you out of this. You got to go to what? Jesus Christ, God Almighty.
Yes.
The blood. Mm-hmm. And number four said that the righteousness of the law may not be fulfilled in us.
Mm-hmm.
Who walk not after flesh, but after the spirit.
Mm-hmm.
If you follow God, the righteousness, you cannot walk after, what is your flesh? Somebody want to know what flesh is? Flesh is in your five senses. That's all it is.
That's right, come on.
What you hear, see, smell, or taste. That's your flesh.
That's right.
And old flesh ain't good for nothing, baby.
Yeah, that's right.
If you ain't got the Holy Ghost, your flesh will send you straight to hell. You will die.
Yes, it will.
That's why it's important to take on the walk of Christ. That's why it's important to believe that God is who He say He is.
Yes.
If you become a believer, then you don't have to worry about death row. How can you be? You need somebody to plead your case. We all stand in need of a Savior. We all are sinners standing in need of a Savior here.
Yeah.
Oh, yes, sir. 5 said, for they that are after the flesh do mind the things of the flesh, but they who are after the Spirit do mind the things of the Spirit.
Mm-hmm.
For to be carnal minded is death, but to be spiritual minded is life and peace.
Amen.
If you follow your flesh every day, if you follow your flesh every day, like Pastor Corey said not long ago, if somebody cuts you off and you get hollered about, you want to cuss them out, you get out and cuss them out. That's what's wrong with the world today. That's why you find folks doing so many things in the world today. Why? Because they're following their flesh.
Amen.
That's why man cannot. That's why children are being abused. Uh-huh. That's why women are being beaten, killed. That's why men are being killed. That's why people breaking in your home. That's why people stealing your car. That's why people trying to take your life for nothing. That's why they're going to these schools right now, trying to kill all, they have all these killing sprees. They get these Uzis, shoot everybody up.